Discussion on coronary aneurysms in Kawasaki disease. Coronary aneurysms can be defined as localized dilatation of the coronary artery of more than 1.5 times compared to the adjacent coronary segment. In children, the classification is often based on SED score. SED score is the standard deviation from coronary artery internal lumen diameter normalized for body surface area. AHA classification of coronary artery aneurysms based on SED score is as follows. 1. No involvement, with SED score less than 2 always. 2. Dilatation only, with SED scores from 2 to less than 2.5, or a decrease in SED score of 1 or more during follow-up if it was less than 2 initially. 3. Small aneurysm with SED score of more than 2.5 but less than 5. 4. Medium aneurysm with SED score 5 or more but less than 5 and absolute dimension less than 8 mm. 5. Large or giant aneurysm with SED score 10 or more or absolute dimension 8 mm or more. The decrease in dimension in class 2 over time means that though the diameter was in normal range initially, it was actually dilated for that person and decreases in size over time. Reference for AHA guidelines 2017. A previous Japanese guideline classified coronary aneurysms in acute phase of Kawasaki disease based on absolute or relative internal lumen diameter. In that classification, small aneurysm or dilatation was a localized dilatation with internal diameter 4 mm or less. In children of 5 years or more, internal diameter of a segment measures less than 1.5 times the adjacent segment. Medium aneurysm was with internal diameter above 4 mm up to 8 mm. In children of 5 years or more, internal diameter of a segment measures 1.5 to 4 times that of an adjacent segment. Giant aneurysm was with internal diameter above 8 mm. In children 5 years or more, internal diameter of a segment measures more than 4 times that of an adjacent segment. This classification is easier to follow as you need not check the nomogram for SED scores each time you do an echocardiographic measurement of the coronary arteries. Disadvantage, of course, is that the variation in coronary size with age is not fully accounted for. A study by Suda and Associates found 76 patients with giant coronary aneurysms from their institutional database since 1972. The average age at onset was about 3 years and the median follow-up was about 2 decades. 7 of them died and 1 underwent cardiac transplantation over the follow-up period. The survival rates calculated were 95% at 10 years and 88% at 30 years. About 2/3 of them had undergone surgical or catheter-based interventions to alleviate coronary ischemia. The authors called for further research on the role of coronary interventions in those with coronary aneurysms following Kawasaki disease. Factors which favor regression of coronary aneurysms in Kawasaki disease. Age less than 1 year at onset of Kawasaki disease. Smaller aneurysms have a greater chance of regression. Distal aneurysms are more likely to regress. Fusiform aneurysms regress more often than saccular aneurysms. Here is the relevant reference. Overall, about half to 2/3 of coronary aneurysms in Kawasaki disease have been shown to regress on angiography within 1 to 2 years of onset of illness. In contrast to coronary aneurysms which can regress with time, stenotic lesions are more likely to progress as they are due to intense myoindimal proliferation. Progression of stenotic lesions are more likely in those with giant aneurysms. Worst prognosis is for those with giant aneurysms of 8 mm or more diameter. Though echocardiography is the most commonly used investigation for aneurysms in Kawasaki disease and coronary angiography the gold standard, MDCT is a useful non-invasive modality for long-term follow-up.
Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.